Indian Outlaw waiting to get in the ring, but laid out is Lennox Lightfoot and Dillinger pouring it on. My goodness, I'll tell you this, I hate to say this, but Santel and Dillinger may work better as a tag team than Hammerjack and Dillinger.
Well, they must have gotten together this week and gotten in the gym because they are a well-oiled machine. Oh, my goodness.
Well, up until then.
Maybe
we jinxed them, but up until then, Santel held the rope down at the wrong time, and Dillinger split the difference.
That's not going to do wonders for date night. I know that, Michael.
Tag made, and Santel coming in, and a tag made across the way. And here comes the Indian Outlaw. Whoa, boy, is he fired up.
He's got the hot foot dance going now.
Wahoo shuffle in the ring, and here is Indian Outlaw popping on Dillinger, smacking him again, taking him and sending him to the floor, and here we go, the war dance, the war chant, Santel sent, and Santel goes down.
That could be it right there, Michael. He nailed that textbook. Oh, and a leg lariat right
there. He wraps him up. This could be it, two and all. Oh, that's all he got. Only a two count. How close can you come?
I thought Rick Santel was done right then, but Rick Santel firing back with a big right, another big right to the outlaw. No, he catches him.
Oh my goodness! Santel put down on his hiatus, and in the ring to break it up is Dillinger, and Dillinger came flying out of nowhere to break up that pinning combination.
Now Lennox is in the ring. The legal man is outlaw. So if he pins Santel, I don't know if that'll count.
Lightfoot again, tomahawk chop, back of the neck. Lightfoot got Santel a reeling. Here we go.
The four wins, tomahawk chop, and here it comes, right here, Michael.
Fans picking up the chant, and Santel moved out of the way just in time. On the floor, it's Dillinger and the big Indian. The Indian Outlaw pounding away, and all the men are on the floor, and we're back to a brawl.
We've got ourselves a regular slobber knocker over here now. All four men out on the floor.
Referee counting five. He's got a five count. All four men on the floor. Paul Adams trying to get his team back in. And now,
Dillinger, where did that come from? Comes flying out on the floor.
You know what? I hate to say this, but I think the Tribal Nation has just been counted out, and they have.
Referee Kurt Heron has given the match.
Paul Adams was keeping Lennox Lightfoot from getting back into the ring while all this mayhem was going on, so it is a count out. The titles cannot change hands on the count out, but Tribal Nation
is
counted out, and the war continues.
These guys are fighting all over the building. Oh, my goodness.
It is all right now. The team of the A-team controlling the brawl.
We've got a downright war. And the match is over, but the war is still going.
Indeed, the fight goes on. And now Paul Adams choking Lennox Lightfoot and choking the life of the referee is on him. And all four men now being involved. Adams is involved. Referee trying to get some kind of order, but there is no order in mayhem.
Paul Adams better be careful.
Eric Andrews to the ring. That should help out. That will even the score. That will put the sides at three apiece and quickly scampering to the dressing room. The 18 get the win, but not the belts. We'll be back with more action right here on Saw.
We'll be right back with more on Saw.
With you here on Saw, Michael St. John and ringside, and Jerry Lynn has asked for some time to talk here. And Jerry, in the past couple of weeks, it has been a literal war for the International Heavyweight title with you and Kid Cash, and I gotta say, some of the best matches, but some of the most brutal fights I've ever seen.
Well, Kid Cash and I are no strangers to each other, but Cash, I've always been one to give credit where credit is due. And no matter how many of these fans think you're an ignorant butthole, you're a very intelligent wrestler. You see, last time we stepped foot in this ring, we had a 15-minute time limit. Hey, and I'll give you credit, you stalled for 8. Always thinking.
Well, he is a man that he is incredible when it comes to – he is a psychological, and I hate to say this, genius. But at the same time, wrestling-wise, you guys just – there's something that is just electrifying. And I've got to say, the gold belt in Saw has to be now – one of the most influential belts in all of professional wrestling because everybody wants to come in here and go for it.
Well, Cash's talent has never been the question. Where the problem lies is his attitude.
Run around and brag about how you wiped the mat with this old-timer's butt and beat me. Well, like I told you before, you didn't beat me. The clock beat me. Well, genius, next week in this very ring, we've got 60 minutes, and I know I can go 60 minutes. So I want you to ask yourself one thing, Cash. What's it gonna feel like when I walk out of this ring? The new SAW International Heavyweight Champion!
Jerry Lynn, Kid Cash, 1 hour time limit next week for the international title right here on Saw.
You're watching Saw, a cut above the rest. More action coming your way next.
So let's go away. Let's make our escape. Come on, let's go away. Let's ask, can we stay? Can you take me higher? To a place. Appreciate those nights and those dreams, but my friend, I'd sacrifice all those nights if I could make the earth and my dreams the same.